back on IG. That's it, Skip. Nothing more, nothing less.
Jenny, yeah. I want to point out to our viewers that Shannon Sharp is celebrating a wrong prediction on the Cowboys Redskins because he picked my Cowboys to beat the Redskins.
Skip, I'm celebrating.
Am I correct about that?
I did pick the Cowboys to beat the Redskins, but that's not what I'm celebrating. I'm celebrating being back on IG. My IG was down for a week, I swear.
Yeah. That's as big a bunch of phony baloney as Al Reveron tweeted after the Cowboy game about the snap.
Jenny.
Yeah.
You and.
Yep.
It's too early, but thank you
it's
for the offer.
Early.
Yeah.
It's early way too early for any of
that. Stop it. You know what? I got something for you. You want would you like a Victor
No,
cigar?
I don't do that.
You don't want anything?
I don't do any of that.
I feel. I'm sorry, Skip. It hurts me. It hurts me that they got missed that field goal. It really did, Skip. It tore me up.
I thought you were getting back in shape. I thought that was the whole idea.
I'm getting back in shape.
Oh, boy.
What
was that? Oh, I got the wood tips, too. Okay. Oh, let's go, Jim.
All right, well, Shannon's ready. I don't know if he's still celebrating the fact that the Eagles lost again. The Patriots did win. That's something good. But you know what? We also had a little spitting going on, Rondo at CP3. We will talk about that later. But we're going to start in D.C. and what we saw between the Redskins and Skip's Cowboys. It was a huge NFC East matchup between the two teams. Let's go right to the fourth quarter when Dak Prescott fumbled. The Redskins scored to go up by 10. Then with under 2 minutes left, Dak scored a touchdown to cut the lead to 3. The Cowboys got the ball back, set up a 47-yard field goal attempt, but a false start was called on the snapper for moving the ball that pushed it back to 52 yards. Skip's not happy here. Mm. Brett Maher hit the upright. The Cowboys are now 3-4. The Redskins are in first place. Let's take a listen to Dak after the loss.
It wasn't our worst performance out there today. It's a lot that we can learn from, we can get better from. And as I said, going into this bye week, that's something that we're going to take. We're going to figure out why we're not doing as well on the road as we're doing at home. And we're going to figure out how to put ourselves in the best position to succeed. We've got a great team. We got great guys in that locker room that all support each other. I mean, I've been part of some good teams since I've been playing the game of football. And this team is special. So our heads aren't down, heads up. And we're ready to get better this bye week and move forward in the season.
Skip, what happened to your Cowboys?
What happened?
The more I think about this, the madder I get. So I apologize if I come out of my seat over this. But my Dallas Cowboys got absolutely robbed yesterday in Washington. And I want to point out for the record, I immediately tweeted about this. So you can look at my timeline. So this is not 2020 hindsight or reaching for some lame, far-fetched excuse. Jonathan Allen of the Washington Redskins jumped offsides unprovoked on said first field goal attempt. My long snapper, my field goal snapper, did not illegally move the football in any way, shape, or form. So it should have been a 42-yard field goal, which clearly if he'd hit it the same way he hit what became a 52-yard field goal, it would have made it around the left upright. But from 10 yards farther, it continued to hook until it caught the left upright. And unfortunately, it didn't carom inside the uprights. It carom straight out, and I lost 20-17. So after the game, Al Reveron, the NFL's director of officiating, tweeted that illegal ball movement by the center caused the defense to come across in the neutral zone and contact a lineman. Baloney! Nothing but NFL spin control. The Cowboys field goal snapper is named LP LaDussard. He has been with this football team the longest tenured of anyone on the team. He's been with it for 14 years, and over 14 years, he snapped for over 400 field goal attempts, and he said after the game, I did the exact same thing I've been doing for 14 years. He got his grip on the football, and once he came set, Mr. Sharp, he stayed set. He did not flinch. He did not false snap it and try to push it back and start over again. He did nothing to incite Jonathan Allen to jump across the line of scrimmage. So in the end, I congratulate and commend Tony Dungy last night on NBC. It was as strong as I've ever heard him. He said he looked at the snap dozens of times, and he said, I could see nothing wrong with that. It was a horrible call, and it was. And it cost the Cowboys an overtime that they would have won. And I know this is just my opinion, but they had all the momentum, as you well know, in the fourth quarter, and I think they would have carried that momentum with a made field goal into overtime, and we would be talking about the 4-3 Dallas Cowboys on top of the NFC East. Your turn.
But they're not 4-3. They're 3-4, and they're not a top. And I disagree vehemently.
You do.
I strongly disagree with your assessment of they were robbed. No one play cost the team the game. No. Haven't you heard that? All these coaches, these great coaches, from Tom Landry to Jimmy Johnson mm-hmm. to Don Shula, mm-hmm. all the great coaches you've been around, mm-hmm. name the one that said one play cost them the game.
That one play cost them the game.
No. I ask you a
it
simple
question. It came down to that. That's all I know. One swing of the leg from 42 would be good. 52 missed.
He could have made this a moot point mm-hmm. by putting it through the uprights. Mm-hmm. If he'd done that, what we'd have be having a different discussion. So does he have the leg strength to make it from 52? Sure he does, because I'm sure he's made one of those before. He had missed his first field goal attempt mm-hmm. in Carolina, and after that he had been, 16-16?
And to his credit, he took full blame and said, I should have made it from 52, but go ahead.
Yeah, he should have. I mean, who else was kicking it? Who else are you going to blame? Oh, Jenny, who, mm-hmm. me? You want to blame me, but I want to go to the bigger issue mm-hmm. and what we know to be the problem, but you don't want to address that, Skip Bayless.
I will now.
No, you won't, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to beat you to the punch because mm-hmm. you had your opportunity. I wanted you to go first.
Yeah, and I didn't want to take 9 minutes to start the show the way somebody else always does, but okay. Go ahead.
Do you want to go talk about?
No, okay,
you
know your what? Turn.
No, I gave you the ball. I'm feeling generous today.
I'm feeling generous today.
I might have you a little sip while I'm over here. You go right ahead, Skip Bayless. I want you to have this. This is your time.
So, my quarterback was a warrior yesterday. He hurt his knee early. Then he hurt his left hand as he got concussed. And I'm pretty sure he got concussed. And I have no idea how he passed concussion protocol because he actually was using smelling salts when he ran back onto the mm-hmm. field. But they let him play, and he played his tail off. But he did make the one mistake on the road you cannot make. And I'll be the first to admit that he's trying to do too much with too little because he doesn't have receivers who can separate, and he doesn't have a left guard who can block anybody.
Don't do this.
They stick with the rookie Connor Williams out of University of Texas. He is a liability. He is a weak link. And on the play before the disaster play, my man Dak Prescott hit Cole Beasley on third and long for a big first down, and I said, here we go, we are in business. Nope, holding on Connor Williams. They got to get him out of there. And what happens on the next play? Dak drops back all the way to the goal line. He tries to hold the ball, do too much, and he gets stripped, and it's a touchdown. And it's hard to overcome that against a good defense on the road, and they should have anyway. Your turn.
Oh, okay. Now that you see, I love how you do that, Skip Bayless. And this is what I've noticed about you in the years of been dealing with you and following your career as you do this, as you are the grand master, the grand wizard.
He studies me. I don't study.
But I study you. There's your fatal flaw right there. Mm. But anyway, see, what you try to do with Dak Prescott, see, Dak is a guy that will set the house on fire. Almost put the fire out and save the house. Mm. He doesn't, but he gives him credit. He started this fire, as you mentioned. Mm-hmm. He fumbled the scoop and score. He fumbled earlier in the game. Mm-hmm. 2 turnovers. Yep. You told me your guy does not turn the football over. Mm-hmm. You told me your guy protects the football. Can you tell me what he's doing now at an alarming rate, Skip Bayless? Mm. Turning the football over. You told me.
I wouldn't say an alarming rate.
Look, all I know is how many turnovers he had his rookie year?
4.
Oh, and how many
interceptions. I don't remember the fumble.
How many he had last year? And how many does he have this year? But it's not your turn to talk, so don't answer that question.
Oh, you're asking me.
No, I'm not asking
you. I thought it was my turn.
See, the thing is that Dak numbers get skewed mm-hmm. by those last two mm-hmm. drives because at 149 total yards, Jenny, and how many points, Skip Bayless? 7. He had how many yards he have in the fourth quarter? This many yards. That's what Dak Prescott had in the third quarter, Skip Bayless.
Four total yards.
Said
in the fourth
quarter. No. Third quarter, he had 4. So 153 yards and 7 points in 3 quarters of football. And then when Washington went prevent, now all of a sudden he want to throw, you know, he looked good.
Oh, so Washington went prevent in the fourth quarter.
Oh, they didn't?
I didn't know that.
They didn't?
Oh, I didn't see when they prevent.
Hold on, Skip, baby.
I didn't see out and out prevent.
Don't do that, Skip.
I saw them just pull out the stops and unleash Dak Prescott, and you saw what happened when he threw 4 in the fourth, 110.
So why didn't they unleash him in the first 3 quarters? So what, they had him caged up?
They often do on the road. I told you, they always play not to lose.
I keep telling you this, Skip Bayless. Once a team bottled up Zeke Elliott, they forced the ball into Dak Prescott's hand. Mm. Now, what we've seen on the road is that he's been unable to deliver time and time again. Now, you keep telling everybody his first 2 years, he had the best road record, tied with Tom Brady. No, he was behind Tom Brady. Mm-hmm. I think maybe tied with Tom. 12-4. That's what he keeps telling me. 12-4
on the road.
Yeah, on the road. That's good too.
Second to Tom Brady.
But the thing that we do in sports is that we must update our resume on a weekly basis.
Yep.
And in 2018, if you don't mind, Skip Bayless, because I know they don't have the stats and the great stat people. Mm-hmm. You have the great Tyler Korn.